As we have set up HBase successfully on our PC, let us go through the basics of HBase. We will start with reviewing multi-node cluster. We have a multi-node lab wherein we have 10 nodes and we have all the services that are part of typical big data cluster on it. That cluster is built using Hortonworks distribution and we should be able to access it using Ambari and we can review the multi-node cluster. Even though you don't have access to the labs, still you can understand some of the key concepts behind multi-node cluster, such as architecture, how it look like, etc. Once we review the multi-node cluster, we will actually go through understanding HBase shell. We'll launch HBase shell and we will see how to get help, how to perform certain operations, so on and so forth. Once we understand HBase shell, using HBase shell, we'll perform CRUD operations and then we'll understand how the schema will look like in HBase. That being said, let us review details with respect to the multi-node cluster. The cluster is set up using Ambari. To access that, you need to have lab access. However, if you don't have lab access and if you are not interested in purchasing it, well and good, you can just follow the content and you should be able to understand some key features with respect to multi-node cluster on which HBase is set up as it is set up in typical production clusters. So here I am connecting to this URL, entered the username and password and logged into this interface. It is called as Ambari. You can see the services on the left. One of the services is nothing but HBase. You can click on it and you can actually see the architecture of the cluster. We have something called region servers. There are 5 of them. One is down for some reason. We need to troubleshoot and restart it. And then we have 3 masters. You can see here. Wherever you have multiple masters for a given technology, that has to be monitored by Zookeeper. Zookeeper provides features such as high availability, load balancing, transparent failure, etc. And even in this case, HBase is plugged into Zookeeper. Even when we set up locally, we have understood that HBase is dependent on Zookeeper. And when we run start hbase.sh command, it starts Zookeeper as well as HBase. That being said, we have 3 masters and then we have 5 region servers. And if you click on region servers, it is taking us to set of nodes which start with WN, which is nothing but worker node. On these nodes, on top of HBase region server, we also have data node and node manager. If you want to get into the properties to understand what HBase look like and what are the key properties with respect to HBase, you can actually click on HBase and go to configs and you can actually review all the key properties with respect to HBase. Here I'm not getting into any details with respect to these things, but this is how you can access the properties with respect to HBase which control the runtime environment. You can actually see the HBase master maximum memory is 1 GB, region server maximum memory is 8 GB. So we have given 8 GB memory on each region server. The reason why we have to give this much of memory with respect to region server is whenever we insert data into HBase table, the data will be first cached into the memory and periodically that data will be flushed into HDFS, which is nothing but the file system that is used to store data permanently. But as HBase is a NoSQL database and as we have to perform writes and reads in real time, that intermediate memory structure will take care of performing the operations in memory along with updating a log file and then flush into the file system at regular intervals. If something goes wrong, the logs can be replayed and we can actually recover up to the point of failure. So this is very brief high level overview about multi-node cluster. I just want to show you how the cluster look like.